Okay, in this video, I'm going to show you how to solve absolute value inequalities. We have three problems to solve, one of each kind. These are sort of test questions. We have an absolute value less than, we have an absolute value greater than, and we have one that's a little tricky here at the end, another absolute value less than. They're all treated a little bit differently. And if you like the video or if these help you in any way, don't forget to hit the like button. Let's go ahead and get started. All right, so here we're asked to solve an absolute value inequality that's less than. We have the absolute value of 4x plus 5 is less than 15. Now we're going to apply the theorem for less than, which says the argument of the absolute value has to be in between plus or minus that number, 15 in this case. So what this means is that negative 15 is less than 4x plus 5, which is less than 15. Okay, so that's what that absolute value means as a compound inequality. Once we have this compound inequality, we could solve that just using regular algebra. So in this case, we would first subtract 5 on all sides, and we get negative 20 is less than 4x, which is less than 10. Okay, and now you can see we need to isolate the x by dividing by 4. And that'll leave us with negative 5 is less than x is less than 5 halves after I reduce. Okay, so that's our answer, but we're also going to want to express our solutions or graph our solutions on a number line. Okay, so let me choose a good scale. I got to get out to 2.5, so, and negative 5. All right, for the lower bound here, negative 5, I'm going to choose an open dot because of the strict inequality. There's no equal there. And then the upper bound is going to be 2.5. So I'll choose an open dot there as well. And then shade everything in between. All right, so all of these x values will solve the original absolute value inequality. Okay, so all that's left to do is express our answer in interval notation. So here we have with a parentheses because of the open dot. So that's non-inclusive. Negative 5 to 5.5. That's infinitely many answers, infinitely many x values that'll solve my original. Okay, so that's how you set up an absolute value less than. Let's do next a greater than, and I'll show you how that one works. All right, so here we have another absolute value inequality. We have the absolute value 2x minus 1 is greater than or equal to 17. All right, so this time we have a greater than. That sets up a little bit different. Whatever's in there in the argument of the absolute value, that argument is either going to have to be greater than 17 or less than negative 17 for this to work. So what this means is that 2x minus 1 has to be less than or equal to negative 17, or 2x minus 1 is greater than positive 17. All right, so that's how we're going to get out from under the absolute value notation. That's what that means as a compound inequality. Now, you have to use the word or. You cannot combine these two. Once you have this, you can then solve each piece just using regular algebra. So I can see here I need to add 1. 2x is less than or equal to negative 16. And then dividing by 2, for this piece we have x is less than or equal to negative 8. Now, over here, adding 1, I get 2x is greater than or equal to 18. And then dividing by 2, I get x is greater than or equal to 9. All right, so we have our two pieces. And what's left here is, that's our answer, but what's left here is to graph our solutions on a number line. All right, so let's get a good scale. It looks like I have to go from minus 8 to 9, so I'm going to make it kind of small. Right. And so in this case, I'm going to use actually a closed dot because of the inclusive inequality. So all the numbers less than or equal to negative 8. So I'll shade all those over here. That's this interval. And then for this piece, we have all the numbers are going to work that are greater than or equal to 9. So I'll use a closed dot there and shade all those. All right, so there's our numbers graphed on a That's our solution set graphed on a number line. And so all that's left to do is translate that to interval notation. So for this piece, we have negative infinity to negative 8, inclusive, so I'm going to use a square bracket, union, inclusive, 9 to infinity. All right, you always leave infinity open with a parenthesis. And that's our infinite number of solutions there to an absolute value greater than. Okay, now there's one more little twist, sort of a test question. We'll do that one next, so stick around. Okay, so here we have one last absolute value inequality. So notice the previous two, the absolute value was isolated. So for this one, we have some operations that go along with the absolute value. And that's the first step. So watch out for that. We're going to have to isolate the absolute value. Be careful here. You cannot subtract 5 minus 3 and make that into a 2. That would be a mistake because these are not like terms. All right, so what we're going to want to do to isolate the absolute value first in this problem is go ahead and subtract the 5. And that'll leave me with negative 3 times the absolute value of x minus 4 is less than or equal to negative 9. Okay, once we're here, we can then divide by negative 3. And these negative 3s will cancel. And that'll leave me with x minus 4 isolated. But we have to be careful. Remember, when we divide by a negative number, we have to reverse the inequality. So this less than actually becomes a greater than. Okay, so once I have it isolated, now I can apply the theorem, which says the absolute value greater than whatever's in there, the argument of the absolute value has to be less than the opposite of that number, right? Or greater than that number. So in this case, x minus 4 has to be less than or equal to negative 3, or x minus 4 has to be greater than or equal to 3, right? That's what it means. And so from here, we can just solve. So adding 4, we have x is less than or equal to 1, or here we'll go ahead and add 4 as well, and we get x is greater than or equal to 7. Okay, so let's graph that. That's our answer. Let's graph that compound inequality. Let's graph the solutions on a number line, right? Okay, so I just rewrote the answer up here, and we'll write our number line right underneath that. So I need to get out the 7. Right, and so 1, all the numbers, x less than or equal to 1, here I'm going to use a closed dot, that's inclusive, so I'll shade all those, and then I'm going to shade all the numbers greater than or equal to 7, so there we go, a closed dot, all the numbers greater than 7, there we go. There's our solution set graphed on a number line, and in interval notation, we can write negative infinity up to 1, inclusive, so square bracket, union, 7 to infinity, right? 7's included as well. So infinitely many solutions to the original absolute value inequality. Just be a little careful when you have multiple operations. The first step is to isolate the absolute value. So you got to do a little bit of work before you apply the theorem. Okay, so watch out for that. And that should get you going on these absolute value inequalities. Don't forget to hit the like button. Thank you and good luck.